First of all, I have to tell you, the mind about which we speak and depend upon is a myth. There's nothing like mind. Brain is reality, not the mind. Mind is created by us reacting to outside. Either we react to conditionings or to our ego. Thus this mind is created like bubbles on the ocean of reality. But that's not reality. With this mind, whatever we decide, we know is very limited, elusive, and sometimes shocking. The mind always moves in a linear direction. And because there's no reality in it, it recoils and boomerangs. Thus, all the enterprises, all the projections so far we have done, it seems, come back to us. Whatever they discover comes back to us as a big destructive power or a very big shock. So one has to decide what to do, how to be out of this trap of our mind. Kundalini is the solution. When she is awakened, she takes you. With that awakening, she takes you beyond your mind. The first thing is to go beyond your mind. With mind, you will do many things, but it will not be satisfying. It will be not a solution, it will not help. And when we start depending too much on our mind, we develop all kinds of physical, mental, emotional problems. Now the latest is the stress. Stress, and the stress has no solution, they say. But in Sahaja Yoga we find the solution by crossing over this mind. So when you get your realization, you must understand that your Kundalini has taken your attention beyond the mind. Now, this reaction to outside has come because we human beings have a prism-like brain, or we can say prism-like skull. And when the energy passes into it, I have explained it in my books, it goes into bifurcations, or you can say refractions, by which our attention goes out and we react. If we react too much, then these bubbles create a very horrible mind which can lead to any kind of thing. It justifies itself, it tampers your ego. The ego and the conditioning that creates this mind start using, and this mind for the purpose of their fulfillment of their all the accumulation of ideas and thoughts, which has no backing, which has no reality with it. Now the first step is to become thoughtlessly aware, where you cross your mind. You go above your mind. Mind cannot affect you. This is the first stage, as we call it, thoughtless awareness. Second one is where you start seeing the working of this Paramachaitanya, of this all-pervading power, and you start becoming aware that there is lot of truth in what Mataji says, that there is this power which works out many things. It works miraculously so many things for you. It gives you blessings, it guides you, it helps you. In so many ways it helps you. It gives you good health, good wealth, and also a very good society. Achieving thoughtless awareness is very simple and easy. But to maintain at that point is difficult. We still react and we think. Anything you see, you react. To get to that point in thoughtless awareness is first to change your attention. So what happens that when you are putting your attention so much to outside all the time, then you must first of all also divert your attention. For example, you see these beautifully made things here. Your attention is something else. Just try to enjoy the beauty of that. See, there are beautiful carpets here. Just look at them without thinking. Because they don't belong to you, so no headache. They belong to somebody else. It's very good. Otherwise, if it belongs to you, you start thinking, oh my God, I've spread in them here. What will happen? They have to be insured or some sort of thing like that. That's common human reaction. But if it doesn't belong to you, you can watch it nicely. Now you watch it and don't think. You'll be amazed when you see the beauty that is put inside this. You'll see the artist who has put his joy, his exuberance into it. And you'll be amazed after realization that this exuberance will fill into you and a cool kind of a relaxation will come into you. And this kundalini will rise and you will become steady in your thoughtlessness. So whenever you look at anything, look at any beautiful thing, even say today's election, just watch the man who is elected. Watching him itself gives him blessings, gives him better ideas. You get also ideas which are coming from reality, which are there, how to make this man a successful person or this country a successful democracy. All these things happen when your attention is diverted from criticizing, from reacting. Just you watch, become the witness, try to witness it. It's not so very yet practiced, so far I've seen, that whenever even we get our achieve our realization, we don't realize that we have to witness it. When you start witnessing through your spirit, then you don't see the bad points of another. In Japan, Zen system started on these lines. And he made, Vijitama was the person who started it. He made a garden out of moss, different moss, very small. There were little flowers also. And hardly about 5 feet of the garden, which looks like a shape of a question mark, you can say. You have to go on a lift and you reach that platform on top of a hill or a mountain where you see this. All little mosses are there and you see differently arranged a beautiful garden. When you start seeing it, your thought stops. Because such a marvelous thing, when you put attention to it, to its creation, your thought stops. So you must practice as to find out what stops your thoughts? What makes you the witness? Once you develop this habit, you will station yourself nicely in the thoughtless awareness. Then you start watching how Sahaja Yoga has helped. You can see from the way it is playing around, its vibrations around me. You've seen so many photographs of mind where these vibrations are there. Also you've seen the photographs of many Sahaja Yogis sitting before me, on their head my name is written down in Arabic language. You've seen so many ways by which you can find out that there is the play of the divine. Now the mind will still try to say something. Don't listen, just watch. So your whole state, spiritual state, becomes so much blissful. You become so powerful. You become so compassionate and so loving, so balanced, completely cleansed with all the destructive ideas you have, all the depressive ideas you have. And then you really stand up as a great Sahaji who can do tremendous work. Because from inside they become completely confident in thoughtless awareness as well as doubtlessly aware. But now, once you start growing by meditative attention, what happens that your attention becomes enlightened. Now the job is to motivate your attention. It's not just to enjoy, but to motivate it, to put it to problems. Now supposing you have some problem on a national basis, you all can put your attention to that and things will work out. Because you are the channel of this all-pervading power, which is trying to create a new world for you, new human beings. And this evolution can take place very fast if you all decide that whatever we have now within ourselves, we should motivate it, we should direct it and put this attention to some use.